now. Fancy a change of career? Maybe you've got a child who can't work out what to do after they leave school. Well, on this, the second day of the big GCHQ cyber security conference in Glasgow, our science correspondent Kenneth MacDonald has a suggestion.
There are 2,500 cybersecurity experts here at the ACC, and that's nowhere near enough. It's predicted within 2 years there'll be 3.5 million job vacancies worldwide, and in Scotland right now, around 500 jobs are looking for people to fill them. What kind of people? Kieran Martin heads GCHQ's National Cybersecurity Centre.
I think we need two sets of cyber skills. We need a small number of really elite, highly skilled people, both in government and in industry, who can do the innovation, who can do some of the fantastic work that we've done. But we also need a whole cadre of people who don't think about cybersecurity each and every day, but who know enough to equip themselves to think about the sorts of risks they're going to face, they and their organisations and their families, and have the right access to the right knowledge and the right equipment to go and do something about it.
Finding enough people to fill those cybersecurity vacancies means winning young hearts and minds. That's one of the aims of the Scottish Government's Cyber Scotland Week. Yesterday in Glasgow and today in Edinburgh, the playwright and director Claire Duffy is doing that with theatre.
We want to reach out to teenagers across the country and their teachers and their parents, hopefully, as well, to engage them with cybersecurity, cyber resilience, and hopefully inspire the digital citizens of tomorrow to be also cybersecurity experts and just really engage with all of the brilliant opportunities there are in digital technology.
The Civic Digits Theatre Company is telling the story of Rupert Goodwins. 35 years ago, he became one of the first hackers to make headlines.
Me and a group of friends discovered flaws in a big British Telecom computer system. We tried to tell BT about it because we used it and wanted to be safe. BT wouldn't listen, so in the end, I was driven to hack Prince Philip's mailbox to try and get a bit of attention for the exploits, and I certainly got that.
Now he wants a new generation to grasp the opportunities offered by what is now a cybersecurity industry.
The government and business is desperate for cybersecurity people, you know, with hundreds and hundreds of vacancies everywhere you look. So one of the things we really hope that the show will do is encourage young people to think, oh, I could do that. That sounds quite fun. And start to think about it when they didn't before, because we need these people desperately.
A background in, say, IT or maths is an advantage, but ultimately even the digital frontier is about people. Josh Goddard is from Leonardo, the cybersecurity firm whose clients include the European Space Agency and NATO.
I think we've all been in the office when we've been frustrated by a security control that's been put in place by our IT, be it remembering a complex password or remembering a dongle to plug into a laptop when it starts up. And it's about explaining to employees why those security controls are there, what they mean, and making it very real for them, so bringing the threat home.
Later this morning, the Cabinet Office Minister David Lidington will be telling the conference about a new cyber fitness tool designed to help public and private bodies beef up their own responses to online attacks.
Ken MacDonald reporting there.